So when I think of Bennu, you know, a lot of people that I meet just in everyday life, they're like, why are you so interested in rocks, right? Like, what is so cool about them? I'm like, because rocks tell you a story, right? And it's the story of Bennu and the history of the solar system that I'm most excited to unravel with the science program. And when we look at the materials, these clay minerals, these carbonates, you had a lot of water moving around in the early solar system beyond what we really expected from our meteorite investigations. You know, when we look at meteorites, we think water moving in very tiny scales, but I imagine a world right at the beginning of the solar system, right in that protoplanetary disk, where you had a lot of ice and a lot of rock and metal and carbon, and radioactivity started heating these things up, and you got massive circulation, what we call a convecting ball of mud, hundreds of miles across, right? And it's in that environment that I imagine these carbon atoms going through the first stages to the origin of life. And to me, that's the greatest mystery that we're facing right now, is like, how do you go from a ball of mud to something that's alive? Like, what happens when you make that transition? And the deepest, you know, desire is that we're gonna make some progress in trying to figure out, what is it? Why is it that we are here, we're alive, we're conscious in this universe? It's such a gift that I hope everybody really stops and thinks about it every once in a while, no matter what your problems are in everyday life. The fact that you're alive and that you're aware on this beautiful planet is something you should be grateful for every day. And that's really where I hope my imagination takes everybody.